Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add the Syncfusion Blazor file upload component to a Blazor server application. The file upload component is used to upload images, documents, and other files. Browse and select the files you want to upload. The selected files will be uploaded to the server on button click. If you click on the clear button, the uploaded files will be cleared from the list. I will show you how to configure the file upload component with a few of its basic features like uploading multiple files or a single file at a time and validation during file upload. We will also see how to save and remove files in the uploader with or without using APIs. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019 or 2022, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor server application using Visual Studio 2022. Make sure that you have installed a compatible SDK version like .NET Core SDK 3.1.8, .NET 5.0 SDK, or .NET 6.0 SDK. First, open Visual Studio 2022 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Choose the Blazor server app and click Next. Name your project and click Next. Then, select .NET 6.0 as the target framework and click Create. A project is created and is ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the file upload component to this project. First, the file upload package needs to be installed. Open the NuGet package manager, search for the Syncfusion Blazor inputs package, and install it in your application. After installation, you will see the package added to this application's packages folder. Navigate to the imports.razor page and import the Syncfusion Blazor inputs namespace. Then, we need to register the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, import the Syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @SyncfusionBlazor method. From 2022 Volume 1 version, the default value of ignore script isolation is changed to true, so I don't have to enable ignore script isolation property here. Next, register the license with a valid key using the registerLicense method to avoid the license validation message. Navigate to the layout.cshtml page within the pages folder and include the script reference externally, since JavaScript isolation is disabled in the source, to improve the application's performance. Then add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 5 CSS reference. Open NuGet Package Manager. Install the package Syncfusion Blazor themes. After installation, you will see the package added to this application's packages folder. From this NuGet package, this Bootstrap 5 style sheet is referred. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can check out the video linked in the card above. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor file upload component to the index.razor page. Include the sfuploader tag. Let me run this application and show you the basic structure of the file upload component. File uploader has two options to upload a file, that is, using the browse button or by dropping files here directly. Use the bin icon to delete the uploaded files. By default, you can select multiple files and upload simultaneously. But to upload a single file, you must disable the allow multiple property. Check now, I can select only one file and upload. Even when I drag multiple files, only the last file will be uploaded. I will show you how to use the other upload types in my upcoming video. Next, I will show you how to save and remove files, to manage the upload process in the server, using server-side APIs or the value change event. Let's see the value change event option first. Events can be specified using the uploader events tag. I include the value change event and assign the callback method on change. In the callback method, I can get the info about the uploaded file using the upload change event argument. I get the file name, set the path as root folder, and save the file using that file stream. In the same way, add the onRemove event to remove files from the uploaded file list. Then I write a remove method, get the file name from the removing event argument, and remove the file if the file exists in the provided location. I'll add the breakpoints to show the uploaded file details while saving and deleting. Check now, when I browse and select a file, the value change event processes the file and saves it. After the file is saved in the desired location, the status file uploaded successfully is shown, and the remove icon changes to bin icon. When I click icon, the breakpoint hits on the remove event and deletes the desired file. File will be removed from the list. Next, I will show you how to save and remove files using the server-side API. In the data folder, I create a web API controller sample data. I write a save method where all the files are processed one by one using the for each statement. Here, I get the file name from the list and check whether that file exists in the provided path and create the file using the file stream. Then I write a remove method, get the file name, and remove the file if the file exists in the provided location. I'll add the breakpoints. In program.cs file, I need to add the endpoint for controller action without specifying any routes. Then I navigate to the index page, provide ID for the uploader component. This should be same as the parameter name in the controller where the file is received. Include the upload array sync settings tag. Add save URL property and assign the save API URL. Likewise, I include the remove URL property and assign the remove API URL. When removing files, I have two options: sending raw file or file name as an argument. I add the before remove event in upload events tag, which will be triggered while removing the files. In that event, I will disable the post-raw-file boolean variable in order to send only file name instead of raw file. Check now, when I browse and select a file, the breakpoint and save API will hit and the file will be processed and saved to the specified root folder. If I click the clear button in the upload list, breakpoint hits the remove API and the file will be deleted. Finally, I will show you how to configure the allowed file types. Include the allowed extensions property and assign the file type PDF. Check here, when I upload Excel files, I get the error message, file type is not allowed. When I browse any location, only PDF files will be shown. By default, the uploader component allows you to upload a minimum file size of 0 byte and maximum file size of 28.4 megabytes. I can restrict uploading large file using min file size and max file size properties. Set min file size to 1000 bytes and max file size to 1 million bytes. Check here, when I try to upload a large file, I get the error message file size is too large. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Blazor server application, add a file upload component to it, and configure a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.